The Woolworths Group, or also known as Woolies, was established on December 5, 1924, 95 years ago. Woolworths Group, or Woolworths Limited, was founded by the five Australian entrepreneurs, which are Percy Christmas, Stanley Chatterton, Cecil Scott Wayne, George Crit, and Ernest Williams. Woolworths Supermarket has grown as the largest market chain operating in the Australia domain, with 995 stores. The business has a compact relationship with 205,000 employees that perform different tasks at appropriation focuses, market stores, comfort outlets, and different areas. They are developing and implementing a corporate social responsibility strategy through its operation with the framework of 3 P's, People, Planet, Prosperity Strategy, aims to address a more diverse workplace inside the company to lessen the carbon footprint that can help to fight climate change and build a strong relationship with the suppliers and to the community.
Statement of the problem. The researcher aims to analyze the impact of the corporate social responsibility strategy of the Woolworths Group on individuals within the organization and how it can affect the world. Understand Woolworths' sustainable plan as to how their short-term and long-term goals can be accomplished to solve ethical dilemmas. Throughout the research, the following questions will be answered. First, how will the Woolworths Group can make sure that their company enables its employees to adopt organizational diversity? How the organization will increase the number of indigenous employees? Second, the Woolworths Group is trying to reduce its carbon footprint by 10%. Will its strategy seem to be helping to minimize global warming? Third, Woolworths is aiming to build a strong relationship with its partners to achieve top quartile ranking. What are their ways to ensure that there will be strong rapport and obtain a strong long-term partnership?
Objectives: to determine Woolworths Group case strategy, to understand the idea of Woolworths Group strategies, to show how the Woolworths Group achieves its goals.
Method: for this research, the researchers chose to use cross-sectional analysis as it is suitable to evaluate the possible solution to the problem and to have a better understanding of the strategies of the Woolworths Group. According to Kendra Cherry, cross-sectional studies are observational and are known as descriptive research, not causal or relational, implying that you can't use them to determine the cause of something. The researcher used a cross-sectional approach to assess if the methods they use to accomplish their goals are successful in embracing organizational diversity, establishing relationship with their partners, and minimizing global warming.
Results: People. Woolworths Group is one of the industry's leading and most prominent retailers. Management seeks to recognize the possible factors that can impact the community and stakeholders by measuring, managing, and modifying cycles to address potential challenges while implementing their corporate social responsibility strategy. Due to the fast-growing business, they aim to create more creative, lively, and inclusive environment inside the workplace to appreciate employees' race, age, gender, ethnicity, religion, beliefs, and sexual identity. They rely more on the specific abilities, competencies, and experiences of the employee. They need to cultivate all eligible employees for management and make sure that they build a career path for them to remain in the business so they can develop not only as a worker but as individual who can contribute more to the company. To ensure that their workers are on the right path, the Woolworths Group has developed different training programs that will strengthen their abilities and skills. Training that the Woolworths Group achieved throughout its sustainability journey in people strategy. They created various training programs and seminars to achieve a more diverse, inclusive culture and to increase indigenous employees. Other action plans that the Woolworths Group took to promote workplace diversity is by improving the representation of women in executive positions and managerial roles.
creating employment opportunities for Indigenous Australians by collaborating with external partners, community-based pre-employment programs, supporting employees and potential employees with disabilities by offering training to individuals to learn sign language to enable the employees to communicate with those employees and customers with disability. Next, promoting age diversity, where they allow older workers inside the workplace with more than 18,000 employees over the age of 55.
In Planet Strategy, the organization is making an important step to ensure that the carbon footprint is minimized to help the world tackle climate change and to ensure the good relationships are established with stakeholders. Woolworths' action in Planet Strategy to reduce its carbon footprint is by minimizing waste. They are collaborated with Oz Harvest, an Australian-based non-profit organization. This collaboration aims to achieve the reduction of food waste towards the following streams: food rescue for hunger relief, donation for animal feed to local farmers, and industrial organic composite recycling. The organization administered a program where the market and sold bananas have been converted into a loaf of banana bread. To help them bring a meal to anyone in need, 50 cents from the profit of each banana bread goes directly to Oz Harvest. During this pandemic, Woolworths was able to support food relief with $1.7 million additional cash for operating expenses, $5.29 million in direct food donation, $1.9 million in paid labor, and $180,000 in transport and logistics. Also, Woolworths Group has been working to reduce its plastic bag waste. Stores along the country are no longer offering single-use plastic shopping bags. The bag for good and unwrap is one of the tools of the company to reduce carbon footprint. In this program, they are using reusable bag as an alternative for plastic bag. They replace their plastic packaging for vegetable with the use of paper tags. They were able to eliminate 237 pounds of plastic packaging. Also, with their approximately 200 stores circulating in the country, they were able to produce more than 6 billion reusable bags, with only 15% of its being from new purchase when visiting Woolworths store. Moreover, the Woolworths Group has been creating programs and ways to fight climate change. They made an energy management where they installed solar panels in supermarkets to reduce the store's environmental footprint and to cut energy costs. With this plan, they are more efficient in refrigeration, lighting, and air conditioning systems. They assume that this plan will not only decrease the store's environmental footprint, but also it helps reduce costs that will offer the most ideal cost to its customers. Lastly, they made a climate risk workshop inside the company where the management can assess the need of customers, suppliers, operations, and the business itself for climate-related transition and physical risks that can impact the business in different ways. With the use of this scenario analysis as a tool to understand the business and enhance the resilience to fight climate change, they are utilizing the situations to see how long-term environmental change threats may affect the retail business.
The Woolworths Group aims to find a way to remain associated and have good relationships with their suppliers, customers, and community. They consider that having a positive relationship will lift confidence that will allow them to have a massive impact. The company stands with honesty and integrity to have a good sense that its clients will be happy to be associated with them by having a good perception of performance. Practicing ethical conduct in the company would enable them to make the best decision to further growth into the future. Besides, it allows them to be guided as the company encounters difficult times, such as rapid growth, and to reduce company's vulnerability to wrongdoing. They are capable of managing the situation in the right way and should avoid confrontation with their employees because ethics guide the company on how to handle the right thing and how to be socially responsible. Among 44 rivals in the business line, the company earned the first quartile ranking of dealing with suppliers fairly and equitably. This is with the help of Advantage Community, where this collaboration helps the company build a forum to resolve suppliers' problems, deepen the customer support relationship, and strengthen the decision-making process that can influence the company and its activities. Allowing suppliers to have a voice can result in a strong relationship since they are more open to discussing problems so they can solve it quickly. The organization wants to emphasize its desire to help the community. The Woolworths Group contributed $1 million to the country's 4 organic farms.
To achieve its goal, the Woolworths company has built a strong culture and strategies that fit the organization's mission and vision. The corporation is also looking forward to the growth of the company. They equip their employees with a strong base of expertise in critical thinking, problem-solving, and decision-making skills to determine the essential strategies carried out by the company. A crucial strategic review of Woolworths was carried out. The performance of the entire analysis revealed that Woolworths' focus is on achieving a higher level of growth in its service. The growth is mainly supported by its deep devotion to its customers and employees. The significance of this case study shows that the external environment conditions that are encountered by the companies will affect their strategies and development. The researchers acquired that there are factors such as political condition in the government influences, shifting social habits, development within consumers, and adverse economic condition within a highly competitive business environment would help them formulate strategies to achieve and maintain a successful business.
The first recommendation is that we acquire that one-time training program will not be enough for the employee in the onboarding process because of the dynamic changes that occur inside the organization. We recommend that the Woolworths Group should conduct a continuous training, coaching, and mentoring program for the employees. This program would help the people inside the organization provide guidance and support for the possible changes or problems that the employee might encounter. Lastly, this program will build up the skill sets and competences of the employees that can be an asset to the company.
Second, we recommend that the Woolworths Group should focus on the convenience of the customers by developing a software or application that will allow them to shop online during this pandemic. This action will help the community to lessen the continued spread of the virus. Next, Woolworths should also acquire continuous innovation where this aspect will be used as a key component of its strategy. This is primarily because the social patterns and desires of consumers indicate dynamism that can be effectively addressed by considering the higher growth rate approach.